Simpson was the man who got in there to block it. Maybe he was the man who started early as well. Maybe they're going to go for two. As the penalty puts
offside
it on them.
Defense.
Now they're going to go for two as they get the kicking team off the field.
With the ball now, you know, on the 1.5-yard line, they have an opportunity to try to go for two. They get 8 points, then a touchdown, a field goal will give them an opportunity to win the ball game.
Well, they've got Titus and Kassan in there at the running backs. Quarterback is Scully. Motion across. Phelan. Scully. Titus, and he does not get it. He does not get it. It was Frank Harden who got to him and pulled him down. Titus was going to drive for the goal line, but Frank Harden made the tackle.
They say Frank Harden's not too fast, not too aggressive. A lot of things he's not, but what he does is make a big play on the two-point conversion attempt. 19 right there. Frank Harden gets good angle, shoulder tackle, makes the play, gives him an opportunity.
So the score is 17-6 with 9.5 to play.
Toyota presents a truck that gives you the feeling.
The feeling that this baby can gut it out.
If it was one play, 20 yards, it took 8 seconds, and Phelan passed 20 yards to Steimer in the end zone. The attempted two-point conversion failed, and so it is 17-6. Eastern Kentucky leading Delaware, and Delaware is kicking off. J.C. Knobloch will do the kicking off. And perhaps an onside kick. At least Eastern Kentucky thinks so. They're protecting against it. We're in the fourth quarter, about 9 minutes, 35 seconds left to play. Tony James is deep, but not very deep. And they let it out. James retreats and takes it at the 8-yard line. He's back to the 10, to the 15, to the 20, to the 25. And it stops at the 30-yard line. John Gannon. And they're on the tackle. So it is first and 10 now for the Eastern Kentucky Colonels. They have the ball at their own 30-yard line. At halftime, the Colonels led by a score of 10-0, but Delaware turned the ball over early in the third quarter, allowing Eastern Kentucky to score yet another touchdown. Take a 17-0 lead, and Delaware just scored their first points of the day, 17-6. Birds in a wide right. Smith follows him out there. He's been everywhere that Bird has been. All day long. Thompson out to the 32-yard line. Paul Brown from Philadelphia made the tackle. Sean Riley from Schenectady also in on the play. It'll be second out and 8 yards to go. 20 carries and for 94 yards for Terrence Thompson from Owensboro, Kentucky. They link up, holding hands in the huddle, and come out. Hill to the left side, Bird to the right side. Tuck Willem, the quarterback. Tuck Willem, setting it up. And a diving attempt at an interception. The pass is intended for Yeast, the fullback. And Sean Riley had a diving attempt, but it's incomplete. Third down and 8 yards to go at 32. Riley's number 58.
Extremely dangerous throw by Tuck Willem. You do not want to do this. We've got a lead. You want to keep the ball away from Delaware. Do not force the ball anywhere. Throw it into the ground. Throw it away from your receiver. But don't give somebody a chance to intercept it. Sean Riley, the outside linebacker, the number one tackle on the team, had a chance.
Brooks and Bird double to the right side. Here's the pass to Brooks, incomplete. About the 40-yard line. Of Delaware, Joe Quigg covering, and here comes the punting unit on. The Colonels are going to have to give it up. Kevin Phelan is dropping back to receive the punt of Steve Rowe. Eastern Kentucky has been in this championship for 3 consecutive years previously. 1979, they won it. That is Phelan waiting to field the punt for Delaware. This is the first time Delaware has ever been to the finals. Trajectory. Phelan is waiting. Fair catch at the 21. No return. So it'll be first and 10. 48-yard punt for the high projection. No return. So they'll start first and 10 at the 21-yard line. And we have 8 minutes, 32 seconds left to play in the Pioneer Bowl.
Born of tradition. Nurtured by pride. Budweiser Light. With a clean, distinctive taste. A light beer worthy of the king. versatile, daring, athletic, and what every kid wants for Christmas.
It doesn't even need batteries.
The toy. He turned their house into a home.
But I love you, Jack.
And their home into a battlefield. Richard Pryor, Jackie Gleason, The Toy, rated PG. Now playing at a theater near you.
Christmas Day on CBS Sports, the Texas Longhorns go head-to-head against senior running back Kelvin Bryant and the North Carolina Tar Heels in the Sun Bowl. Holiday greetings on CBS Sports. If there's any advantage to Eastern Kentucky, it's the fact that they've played on AstroTurf this year four times. They're unbeaten coming into today's game. The only loss that Delaware suffered this year was to Temple on AstroTurf at Franklin Field in Philadelphia. So that may be the determining factor in this contest. Back up to Lindsay and Steve.
All right, Charlie Neal. It's going to be Delaware with the football now. First down, 10 yards to go. They have it at their own 21-yard line. They're trailing in the ballgame. Eastern Kentucky leads 17-6. 8.5 minutes left to play in this game. Kelly is the quarterback. They move Truman up to a wing left. Motion across from Phelan, wing back right, give it to the fullback up the middle. He goes to the 25-yard line, and that was Rick Titus from New Jersey. Again, 4 yards on the play. It'll be second down and 6 yards to go. Here comes Pat McGee into the ballgame, offensive lineman now for Delaware. 66. Reporting the next play under his quarterback, Rick Scully from Newark, Delaware. They've got Paul Hammond in a wide left at good speed. Scully. Goes across the middle. Taken by Titus. He's throw back at the 31-yard line. That'll be just about a first down. David Hill in to make the tackle. Maybe a shade short.
Again, straight drop back. Well, a little bit of an angle to the left by the quarterback, Scully, 14. He goes to Phelan, number 42, across the middle. They have been successful when they've done a little bit of a play action to hold and freeze the linebackers, then to throw the ball across the middle. They're going to have to do a little bit more of that, keep the linebackers out of being able to drop defensively to cover them the pass, to give them a chance to get a big play across the middle.
Measuring for the possible first down. First and 10. At the 31-yard line. Scully is now 6 for 19, 64 yards in the air for Delaware. Here comes Doug Martin back in the ballgame. He's from Union, New Jersey. Pat McGee is coming out. This time Hammond goes to a wide right. Titus is the lone setback. Hammond in motion. Titus with the ball. Pull back up to the 33-yard line. Randy Taylor from Cincinnati, Ohio, made the tackle. Gain of 2 makes it second down and 8 yards to go.
Again, Lindsay, where they have had the success today, when they have thrown the ball and when they've had receivers open, is when they were able to have some sort of very quick misdirection fake, play action fake inside, and then to throw across the middle behind the linebackers who have been frozen by the fake.
Motion again to the wing back, Phelan. Fake to him. Bootleg by Scully. Scully takes the loss back to the 29-yard line. Lost 4. That'll be 3rd and 12. Alan Young got to him. He's from Louisville, Kentucky. 5th sack of the ball game. Steve Davis, I thought that you were especially outstanding in the parade yesterday. You know, it takes a lot of talent to balance yourself on the back seat of a convertible automobile and wave with both hands at the same time.
We're told that's Nicky East's father, the fullback of Eastern Kentucky. Yeah, but, you know, I had a good time with the parade yesterday. I got to throw out a little bit of candy and ate a little bit of candy.
The only disconcerting thing is when you wave at somebody on the side and they don't acknowledge it and don't wave back.
That's right. Most people look, who's Steve Davis?
You feel a little deflated when that happens. It happened to me all day, as a matter of fact.
Oh, well. But they knew us at the chili dinner.
They really did. They were ready for us. Delaware has taken a timeout here. Coming up, the NFL today, and then the Los Angeles Rams and the Los Angeles Raiders. And that's all coming up following this game. You'll get a look at hometown Heisman hero Marcus Allen. Halftime of the Rams-Raiders game. Giants general manager George Young, coach Ray Perkins on his way to Alabama, and Bill Parcells on his way to Perkins' job. 11 yards to go at the 29. They move Kassan over to a wing left. Frank Phelan in motion from a wing right. Skelly with the ball. Oh, my. Incomplete. It'll be fourth down, and the punting unit comes on.
As we said earlier, the football coaches at Delaware said the key to the football game would be Rick Scully, the quarterback, being able to run the football and his ability to throw the ball and establish the fullback game. That has not been, they've not been very productive at all. Rick's had a tough year.
Tyler salute the punting.
Coming this way.
Nobody very deep. They're going to let him punt. Fair catch by Bird, but signal went up. It's made by the man on the other side, which is Frank Harden, which is all right. 21-yard punt, no return, and the ball will be at the 50-yard line. They'll start first and 10 at the 50-yard line. Eastern Kentucky leading in the ballgame by a score of 17-6.
Ollie, I think we're lost.
That's because I can't see out this window.
At the Pioneer Bowl in Wichita Falls, Texas, high there.
That's the way we were waving after the chili last night.
The way it was at the parade. Nobody waved back. 6 minutes, 20 seconds left to play in the game. Eastern Kentucky leading 17-6. And the Colonels have the ball at the 50-yard line. Terrence Thompson has carried 20 times for 95 yards.
Look up now, brother.
Thompson fumbles the football. Delaware is on it. It is Bill Malley. Bill Malley is on the ball. And so now, Delaware gets another shot here with 6:14 on the clock, and they get it at the 45-yard line.
What a break for Delaware. When you think Eastern Kentucky, all they've got to do is just control the ball, put the ball away, Terrence Thompson, Roy Kidd saying. Bill Malley, number 21, just happens to be at the right place at the right time, gives Delaware some chance.
All right, let's see what Delaware does at this time. Last time after a turnover, they came with a reverse pass into the end zone. They were a little closer then. First and 10 at the 45. That's Phelan in motion across. He threw the halfback pass. Skelly still has the ball. Lofts it up there. Titus has got it. And he is at the 32-yard line of Eastern Kentucky. Dominguez, the linebacker, made the tackle. First down, 10 yards to go for the Blue Hens now at the 32-yard line.
Titus, the fullback, comes out of the backfield, 47. McGinnis, number 46, has got to make the play. But what was great about the play is Scully held it up just perfectly. A well-thrown ball, caught the trajectory, made the completion.
Clement's not sure. Now he's evened up, 22. And completed the 20-yard line. Phelan takes it on down inside the 5-yard line. Kevin Phelan. The defender was David Simpson, who's in there for Gus Parks on that corner. Brought to the inbounds marker and spotted now at the 4-yard line. First down and goal to go.
To be a good passer, you do not have to throw the ball hard every time. Watch Phelan, 42, catch this well thrown. Look at the trajectory, just perfect soft pass. And Phelan, once he catches it, knows what to do with it. And it takes David Simpson, 30, to push him out of bounds.
They got a double tight end alignment now. Hammond has come off the field. Tim Sager's in there along with Mark Steimer. Trying to get a little power down here. Short yardage near the goal line. Touchdown. Taken by Sager. Tim Sager, the tight end who just came into the ballgame, on the pass from Rick Scully.
Watch the fake inside. Watch the flow. Look at the bodies going different ways and the flow across of the linebackers. That was Sager that went by the camera right there all by himself. You get too many people moving, the flow, and then all of a sudden, the ball's there.
They're going to go for two to try to make it 14 so they could tie it. I beg your pardon. Timeout. Timeout. Eastern Kentucky takes a timeout. So as you were. Score is 17-12 right now. 17-12. And Delaware was up there to try for two. So that if they made it, it would be 17-14. And then a field goal would tie it. And there are no ties in this championship series. The tiebreaker is in effect. The history of the game and the Sun Bowl. Well, the Sun Bowl is the Sun Bowl. And you've been seeing it on CBS for a good many years. Outstanding game this year, North Carolina and the University of Texas. You see Delaware there along the sideline. Clock says 5 minutes, 38 seconds remaining to be played in this football game. Tubby Raymond, the head coach, the veteran head coach of Delaware. In three plays, they went 55 yards. It took only 36 seconds. Scully, 3 of 3, 55 yards on that particular drive. So now they're going to go up there, try for the two-pointer, which would make it 17-14. That's Titus moving to a wing left. Scully's a quarterback. Now Scully's got the ball, throws into the end zone. Touchdown! Mark Simon, two-point conversion. Two-point conversion. 17-14.
Tight end will fall in behind Pete Jackson, 39. The linebacker and McCullough, 27. All by himself. Delaware's gotten on track, Lindsay.
Delaware now will kick it off from the 40-yard line. The deepest, it'll be Knobloch kicking it off, and the deepest man is Tony James, although he is at about the 14-yard line. Still fearful of the possibility of Delaware trying the onside kick. Here comes Knobloch. Going to give it the full rod. It is fielded at the 23-yard line by James. Gets across the 25. And he's stacked up there at the 27-yard line. So Eastern Kentucky gets the ball. New Frock made the tackle. Delaware coach, Debbie Raymond. Former coach and director of athletics, Davey Nelson, is in attendance, of course, here at the Pioneer Bowl. For so many years, he has been secretary of the rules committee and editor of the rule book, which is a tough job. After you pass it, say it like you mean it. Sometimes that's difficult to do. Doug Willems, the quarterback. Thompson and Yeast are the I-backs. That's Yeast. The fella just keeps plowing. Gets out there to the 36-yard line. Second down, less than a yard to go. Lou Rita from Yonkers, New York, made the tackle. Roosevelt High in Yonkers, New York. Yeast has carried 14 times for 36 yards here this afternoon. Steve Barrett comes to the far right, and right with him is George Smith. He's been sticking him all day. Piling up there for the first down. Yeast got it first and 10, so they keep the drive alive. 39-yard line. Clock is indicating 4 minutes, 50 seconds. Stopped, of course, for the first down, but started again just now when the ball was marked ready for play. That's a good look at Tuck Willem from Pineville, Kentucky. Alvin Blunt and Steve Bird, wide receivers. So Thompson. Aaron Thompson to the 45-yard line. Picked up 6 on the play. It'll be second down and 4. Ron Rossi made the tackle along with Joe Quigg. 22 carries for Thompson, 106 yards.
Joe Quigg, number 19 of Delaware, has outside containment. Watch Thompson cut right inside Quigg right there. He is blocked. Gives him an opportunity to make 2 or 3 yards.
Second down play coming now for the Eastern Kentucky Cornhuskers, trying to win the national championship here this afternoon. East again. Find some running room, gets across the 50 and on down to the 45-yard line of Delaware. Mike Harris finally brought him down. First and 10.
Nicky Yeast really is a tough runner inside. He is short, 5'10", 5'11", weighs 236, and he is a bull. You better tackle him in the right spot to get a real headache.
Alvin Blunt is brought in the next play. He is from Jacksonville, Florida. Comes to a wide right out of the huddle. Yeast and Terrence Thompson are in the I formation. Chuck Willem. Quick pitch to the clear by Thompson. That's this one. Got a yard to the 44-yard line. Lou Rita made the tackle. It'll be second down and 9. I was doing Canadian football one year when they had a coach named P. Head Walker coaching Montreal. And I said, P. Head, how'd you learn to handle 12-man football? He said, well, I send the flank away outside. They cover him to one, and then we play 11-man football. That's what they've done here today. They flank Bird way out, Smith covers him, and they play 10-man football. Well, I'm waiting for the snap. Get a good fullback east. Mickey East to the 42-yard line. Picked up two on the play, make it third down and about seven.
In the games of the past where Eastern Kentucky have lost in the national championship ball game, it's been because they have been plagued with too many turnovers. They've had three today. The Delaware's won. Now all they've got to do is concentrate on controlling the football. Don't make a critical mistake. Each mistake they've made, at least two of the three mistakes they've made in turnovers, have resulted in Delaware's score.
You saw the indicative information. 2:14 now on the clock, and Tubby Raymond with his head down to the sideline because he can't do a thing until his team gets the ball. Eastern Kentucky, coach Leroy Kidd, has the ball. They intend to keep it, apparently. That's Thompson again. He's been the running star of the day for Eastern Kentucky. Hurdling his way forward. Valentina and Hardenshield were in there to make the tackle. It's going to be fourth down, about 2 yards to go. Line of scrimmage is the 37.
Here's a situation where it's fourth down and two. They're probably going to get the ball. They probably will not fair. They probably have to fair catch the ball. Do you try to block it, or do you try to let him kick? You're not going to get a return probably, so I would imagine they'll try to block it.
Rowe is in to do the punting. You saw Phelan deep. That's Tubby Raymond.
Go off the kicker!
Now the whistle. Penalty marker has been dropped, and it's going to be delay of game. We want to thank our spotter, Bill Friel, the pride of Norristown, PA, and our statistician, Roger Riley. Our thanks to Ronnie Autry, Bob Schwartz, and all the folks at the Pioneer Bowl for their marvelous hospitality and cooperation during our stay here. And our thanks to the two competing universities, the University of Delaware.
Dan Biles, delay of the game, offense.
Our thanks to Director of Athletics, Davey Nelson, SID, Ben Sherman, Head Coach Tubby Raymond and his staff, and from Eastern Kentucky, Director of Athletics, Don Coombs, SID, Carl Park, and Head Coach Roy Kidd and his staff. Gets the punt away, high trajectory, really short, fair catch signal goes up, and dropped by Phelan. Scrambles to try to get to it. It's inside the 5-yard line. And Delaware retains possession, but it's inside the five on a 33-yard punt. He got away from Phelan. Technical directors, Bill McKechnie, Joy Grohl, and audio, Tony Hines, Jim Butka. Pass play along the sideline, but incomplete. He was across the sideline marker. It was Paul Hammond for whom it was intended. It'll be second down and 10 yards to go. Ball back there on the 2-yard line. 10 for 25, 121 yards is Rick Scully. Clock says 1 minute, 3 seconds remaining. Eastern Kentucky leading Delaware 17 to 14. It's complete up the middle. Out across the 20-yard line to the 23-yard line. Completed to Clement from Burlington, New Jersey.
Big play. Doesn't really make a whole lot of difference now to run a play action. It doesn't do you any help, any good, really. This time, Scully's dropping back. He's going to go across right across the middle. The linebackers have dropped their underneath. They're out of position. Clement, number 22, makes a reception.
Delaware has taken a timeout, so now let's go to New York to Brent Busberger. Brent?
Lindsay, you've wound up with a dandy finish to that game. Era, I won't see you again until New Year's, but Merry Christmas.
And the same to you, Brent.
All right, Era. And for our fans, we're going to be going out next to the Los Angeles Coliseum for the battle of that city. It is the Rams and the Raiders. And coming up, it'll be the NFL today. Phyllis George will tell us all about Marcus Allen. And Jimmy the Greek will tell us who's going to win that game. And now, let's go back to Lindsay Nelson.
All right, Brent Musburger, right here. We're ready for the fire engine finish. 55 seconds left to play. Eastern Kentucky leading 17 to 14. First down for Delaware. They have the ball on their own 23-yard line. Rick Scully, the quarterback. Running backs are evened up. Scully with the ball rolling and looking and throwing. And it is incomplete to Phelan at the 38-yard line. The defender there was Anthony Jones from Ocala, Florida. Second down and 10 at the 23. For Delaware, this is it. There's no point in saving anything at all because they have 49 seconds left in the season. Each team has 49 seconds left in the season. Eastern Kentucky leading by 3, and this game is for the national championship. Division 1 AA. Scully, penalty marker on the play is complete to Hammond up at the 30-yard line, but it's the linesman's flag across the field. It'll have to be checked out here. Procedure against Delaware.
Procedure on the offense. Repeat second.
Second down 15. Back now at the 18-yard line. Incomplete to Phelan. He tried to pull it in with one hand. Mike Mims was covering defensively. At the 18, 30 seconds on the clock. Over the shoulder and marked up there at the 36-yard line to Clement. Clement right over the shoulder. That's the clock with 23 seconds left to play.
You'll not see a better catch. Watch Cliff Clement, number 22. Scully, it's a throwback pass. Everybody's going to the left. Watch this. Over the shoulder. Look at the extension, concentration of the ball. Sticky fingers.
Clement's caught 4 for 48 yards. First and 10 at the 36 for Delaware, trailing by 3 points. Scully now moving, and the clock is running off the while, and it is almost intercepted. Almost as Mike Mills, number 15, made the move on the ball. Roy Kidd thinks you got to make those interceptions. 15 seconds left on the clock.
The important thing that Delaware, they don't have to go and score a touchdown. All they need to do is get in a position where they can get a field goal, the 10th, tie it up, then they go into a tiebreaker situation.
Exactly what they're trying to do here. Bird along there with his coach, Roy Kidd. He's been stuck pretty well today by Schmidt. Clement. All down near the 50-yard line by Pete Jackson, number 39. 6 seconds left on the clock. And a timeout, Delaware. Ball is going to be spotted at the 49-yard line of Delaware. First down and 10 yards to go. I think that's Delaware's last timeout. It is. And there's a Delaware man down near the sideline. Is that Clement, the man who caught the ball? It is.
The pass again to Clement across the middle. Let's see if we can see. Couldn't get out of bounds right there. Pete Jackson made the tackle. It looked like it rolled up over his ankle. Key is no timeouts remaining. Now they've got to go the length of the field to get a touchdown. It'll be very tough to get 2 plays out of the 6 seconds.
Clement has come out of the ballgame now, and Kassan has come in to replace him. And players resumed. It'll be first down at 10 yards to go for Delaware. They have the ball at their own 49. They're trailing by 3 points. Eastern Kentucky leads it 17-14. 6 seconds left on the clock, and this is the national championship in Division 1 AA. Keep in mind, immediately following this game, the NFL Today will bring you up to date on all the football news, and then you'll see the NFL game, the Raiders against the Rams, right here on CBS. That's Phelan in motion all the way across. Scully pumps once, goes long, and it is Hammond, and it's incomplete. Kentucky wins it 17-14. We'll be right back after a word from your local station.
This is CBS.
Terrence Thompson, who had an outstanding day, and the Chevrolet Most Valuable Player from Delaware is George Schmidt, who had the job of guarding Steve Bird all day long, and he did. A check in the amount of $1,000 will be donated by Chevrolet to each school's general scholarship fund to further assist students in all chosen fields of academic endeavor. The national championship has been won by Eastern Kentucky and Loy Kidd. It is the second time that they have won it. Coming up next, the Los Angeles Rams meet the Los Angeles Raiders at the Los Angeles Coliseum, starting with the NFL today at 3:30 Eastern. This is Lindsey Nelson with Steve Davis and Charlie Neal, saying goodbye from Wichita Falls, Texas, where the final score is Eastern Kentucky 17, Delaware 14. And the NCAA 1AA champion for 1982 is Eastern Kentucky. NCAA football is...
And they blew that, losing 35, I believe it was. 35-23, yes it was. And now 49ers have a second down and one. The ball at the 22 and Ring held short of a first down. Montana thus far on the night, 20 of 30, 252 yards and two touchdowns.
Kind of an average night for Joe.
The halftime stats. Look at them, and then we'll show the transition to the third quarter.
Rushing yards are impressive. They still are.
Look at that. Big change there. Caught up in passing.
Well, the Rams have more total yards than the 49ers.
Right. That's right.
Third down, less than a yard. Jeff Moore, he did not get it. And the crowd with sprinkled with a lot of empty seats loves it.
Well, let's see if they go for it or take the field goal.
They're going to go for it.
They got the best intermediate distance kicker probably in football in Worship.
He's going to go for it.
They'll be inches short.
But I don't know what he's going to call because he has not much confidence in his running game, and twice from a half yard away, he hadn't been able to make it.
Looks Let's a little see. Distressed, doesn't he?
I'm not sure he wants a timeout.
Here comes a Worship. And I'll tell you, they're going to get in time trouble. There's 15 seconds on the 30-second clock.
20-17. A touchdown. If he makes it, a touchdown with
38-yard attempt. And Rushing drills it right through the uprights.
He did the right thing. Walt Michaels would have been the most second-guessed coach in football had he lost last Sunday. He has shooed the field goal. He did the right thing. Field goal can't tie. We'll be back.
Michelob Life is a winner this time, huh?
Oh, you enjoy being buried in the sand.
Michelob Light for the winner.
Would good friends really play this hard for a beer? Well, it is Michelob Light, the rich, smooth taste you can compare to any beer you like.
Michelob Light for the winner.
Ah, the sea, the sun, the sand.
The check.
The check.
I like it.
If you really like it.
I really like it.
We can help you get it. We're TMAC.
I want it.
We're TMAC Financing.
Looking for value? It's here at your GM dealer. So pick out your new GM car or truck and get GMAC financing at rates that make good sense.
Now at participating GM dealers, get low 10.9 financing on new 82 models.
We got it!
This year, there will be no doubt. Number one, Georgia. Number two, Penn State. The game for the national championship. The Sugar Bowl, New Year's night on ABC.
Phone home, I want to go home.
Oh, E.T.?
That might be the real one.
Looks like the real one, I'll tell you.
Here in Los Angeles, anything. 6-point lead now. San Francisco over the Rams. This is Brett taking Worthing's kick. And Barry Ritt breaks away. A rookie from Richmond. First round draft pick, he was, gets it out good field position for Los Angeles out around the 38-yard line.
All right, here comes the rookie from the University of Richmond. He makes some pretty good moves. He makes a man miss. Another little juke step. He makes McCall miss.
That's fine running.
That's very good running. Jeff, you know, in watching Bill Walsh go for the field goal instead of the half-yard plunge, it shows that he has really no confidence in his running
exactly.
game at all. And so he went for the field goal, fearful that he couldn't make the half yard.
First down and 10, 38-yard line for the Rams. Bergamo has a man open, Denard, and he's tripped up, and he'll get the call.
Well, I'll tell you what, he could get the call on Denard, but Denard used his left hand to kind of warn Eric Wright away, but let's see.
Eric Wright covering.
Watch Eric Denard. Watch Denard's left arm. Yeah, see if he pushes away or not. Well, they're both pushing a little bit, aren't they? Who did they call it on?
They're going to call it on the 49ers. Eric Wright.
Number 21, defense, first down.
Well, as we said, it's a judgment call. It depends on which way you want to do it. I thought they were both pushing.
Hey, I liked it, Eric Wright. He could have had a lot of things to talk it over with the official. He didn't say a word. He swallowed it. He knows it's not going to change things. Denard again out to the left. Again against Eric Wright. Willie Miller split to the right. First down and 10. The ball at the 43-yard line of the 49ers. Wendell Tyler, and he's ripped up.
But he had nothing going anyway, Giff.
No let it go. Going. He'll lose a couple.
It is very difficult to sweep a three-man line, four-linebacker defense because the quickness of the linebackers can go and pursue so quickly. And he had nothing.
They'll mark it just outside the 43-yard line. So call it second down and 11. Passing situation, good opportunity for blitz on the part of the 49ers.
You know, from this shot, you can really watch the coverage. You can watch the pass rush of the defensive lineman. This shot.
Two wide receivers fed to the left, and Mike Barber is split to the right, the tight end. Draw play. Tyler played very nicely by Willie Harper. And Hippers are soaring a little bit,
heating up a little bit.
And personal.
Wow. That's a big, big break for the Rams.
It sure is.
Let's watch it. Here's Tyler on a draw.
Harper's there first.
That's Willie Harper. 59. Here comes Tyler trying to get around him, but cannot get around him. Good hit there. There's Hacksaw Reynolds coming in.
I think that's who they're calling.
Oh, my goodness. He was still squirming. He was still squirming. I don't see that. Hacksaw, the man was still up when he made his tackle. Let's watch it. Let's see if he's still up when Hacksaw makes the hit. Here's Harper. He wasn't all the way down.
Well, it certainly wasn't necessary either.
No, I agree with Frank.
But he wasn't down, and he had a right to tackle him at that particular point. He didn't try to.
Well, he obviously didn't. It was first and 10, Rams. 26-yard line, 49ers. Tyler, good move, out of scrimmage, but he runs into a pair of 49ers. Pillars was there. Dak Reynolds right at the line of scrimmage.
We have seen many cheap shots the last few weeks, one in the Jet game.